Welcome back to Live with Aaron and Kelly. I'm Aaron Michael Sanchez.
And I'm Kelly V. Dolan.
And today we are joined by Chicago's very own, Kelly Chicago,
well,
I should say.
Well, let's properly introduce it. We've actually got Mo Gallini, who's on Chicago Fire. So we are so excited to have you. Are you there, Mo?
I'm here. Thank you so much for having me. How are you guys doing today?
We're doing great. Hey, Mo, are you actually in Chicago right now?
I am actually in Los Angeles right now. I got to sneak away.
Hey, you're local.
Sneak away. Hey, I'm from
Chicago.
I'm from Chicago. What's it been like filming there?
It's been unbelievable. The city really has opened up their arms and really embraced us being there. And I had never been to Chicago before we shot the pilot in March, and it's such a great city. I really, really like being able to walk everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, you don't need a car. You can just, you know, feel the energy off the streets. It's great.
Oh, is that how it is? Okay.
Oh, absolutely. What have the people been like having you guys there? You know, they don't get too many films and too many TV shows. What's been the response from the people there?
They, like I said, I mean, they really just opened up their arms. They really are excited to have us there. Mm-hmm. And especially, you know, portraying, you know, these selfless heroes, these firemen, and that they're kind of honored that we're in their city.
Yeah, I gotta say, Mo, from what I can see, the sets are so realistic that, correct me if I'm wrong, I don't know if you know about this, but a news station was overhead on one of your plane scenes, and they mistook it for a real accident. They actually reported it as an accident. Did you see that?
They did. I was back in Chicago just right after that happened, and there seems to be like a little running joke with that news station now. So I don't know if our producers have something up their sleeves for them again. I don't know what's going on, but it was the story of the day.
Exactly.
Big kudos to the set design, I guess, huh?
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm surprised that doesn't happen more, because when I show up to work, I mean, we've had to rescue people under trains and stuff, and the people are overlooking and seeing what's happening. I'm surprised there's a lot more emergency calls going out for something that just happened.
Yeah, Mo, I saw actually last week's episode, which was that with the train, where it was pretty gruesome.
Yeah.
One, I think the boy was okay, but his leg was messed up, and his sister just got completely trampled on. And it was nice because it hit home with what firemen deal with on a daily basis, or sometimes, you know, in tragedies. But I got to ask, we had posted that we were going to interview you, and Mike Chania had actually wanted to ask, what kind of training did you get, if any, for this role?
Well, right from the start, when we were there in March to shoot the pilot, like I think it was my second day in Chicago, I went to supposedly the worst area of Chicago, Englewood, to do a 24-hour ride-along.
Oh.
And I really got to see what they did on a minute-to-minute basis. And I really had no idea. I just thought firemen, you know, there's a fire or something, they go to that.
That's what you think, right?
Yeah.
Protectors. Yeah, there are protectors in our community. They, if someone needs help, they are there in a blink of an eye.
Yeah, I have to say, when I saw that on the show, I think they cover a gamut of different situations, and it does remind you, wow, they're doing a lot.
And I will say this, being from the city, when I watch the show, I do feel like I'm right there. So big kudos to the producers who decided to actually shoot in Chicago. And just the style that they're shooting in, it really makes you feel like you're right there with you guys. And, you know, again, just being from there, recognizing the streets, and I'm like, okay, I believe it. I believe you guys are there. I believe that, you know, the intense situation that can happen. Your performances are great. Yeah, man, congratulations on all that success. Now, one of my biggest questions for you is, are you a Cubs fan or a White Sox fan now?
You know, I haven't been swayed. I grew up in Miami before there was baseball, so I never was a huge baseball fan. I've always been a big football fan. And then coming to L.A., we have no football team here, so I'm kind of a lost soul trying to search for a team.
Well, the Bears are doing good this year.
So they're
yeah,
on their way.
Yeah, they are. They are.
Okay,
yep.
So I got to ask, from what I understand, your role, and correct me if I'm wrong, but your role was originally only signed for the pilot, but somehow it got picked up to go for the rest of the show. How did that happen?
Well, I've had a working relationship with the writer, executive producers, Michael Brandt and Derek Haas. They wrote Too Fast, Too Furious, which I was a lead in. So they had me in mind for this Vargas role, but he was supposed to die in the pilot. So the day before we started shooting, we were doing a table read and being streamed to the president of NBC. Back here in L.A., and the next morning I got a call from Michael, the writer, producer, and he said, I have good news and I have bad news. He goes, the bad news is you're not going to get to do all the cool stuff and fall through three floors to your death. He goes, but the good news is you're going to live and we get to start writing for you. So here I am.
Yay.
And that's awesome.
If you guys tune in tonight, they really have written me such a gift of an episode. I was so excited when I got that script in my hand, because it really, you know, after 20 years in the business, I mainly have played the bad guy, and mm-hmm. just to get to stretch my wings with tonight's episode, it's really all I can say is it's such a gift that I've been given.
That's awesome. That's
great job, you yeah. know. And again,
thank you.
From what I understand, you kind of stumbled into the industry with Rudy, which was one of my favorite
yes.
movies of all time.
Yeah.
What was that experience
like?
It's
still one of my favorites.
Yeah, it seems like you keep stumbling
you
into
know,
things.
I used to work in a bar in Santa Monica, and the director, he would always come in. And he knew my friend and myself played football, and he goes, look, I'm doing this movie. I don't know if you guys want to come and be a part of it, but, you know, it's going to be pretty cool. And we're like, okay, where do we sign up? And, you know, we hopped on a plane to Notre Dame, and we were being filmed by NFL Films. We got to play football again, which I thought I was done with a long time ago. And we got to play at halftime of two Notre Dame games
wow.
in front of the whole crowd. And to this day, it's still one of my favorite experiences, because I didn't know what it was like to make a movie. And I spent 5.5 weeks in Indiana and really got to learn what the day-to-day process was. And it was just such a great learning experience. And it really just got me excited to commit to doing this for the rest of my life.
Well, I got to say, Kelly here, I know you can't see her, but she has the Notre Dame shirt.
I actually do. I got the Notre Dame shirt on, so I'm a huge fan of you, just for the simple fact I grew up I grew up in Chicago, and I also grew up a Notre Dame fan. Now, really quickly, you've had a great career, and it seems like you've done a bit of traveling with your acting career. What do you think is the main difference from booking a job that works in Los Angeles versus booking a job in Chicago or Indiana?
Well, I have to say, in the beginning of my career, it was very exciting to get to go someplace new.
Mm-hmm.
But now, having a little 3-year-old daughter, it's really hard to be away from her.
Sure.
Like it kind of breaks a piece of my heart every day that I'm away from her.
By the way, Mo, that's a good thing. I like to hear that, because fathers that don't even think that of their children. Mm-hmm. You're obviously a very good father and a very, very good husband. Now I got to ask. James Garner, you met James Garner. What was that experience like? I was a huge fan of Rockford Files, and I find out you are too.
Oh, God. I mean, I grew up watching the Rockford Files with my father, you know? And you have these surreal experiences where, you know, here you are a few years removed from being that kid, and now you're sitting with this man who at the time had been in the business for 50 years, and he's sharing all these experiences with you. And I was just, and he's just such a loving man. He really just took me in. There was one specific day where it was just him and I working, and I cherish those moments. I mean, I had that moment with him. I had a moment like that with Rod Steiger, who one of my favorite movies of all time was On the Waterfront. And
yes.
I had I got to work with him in End of Days, and all my friends were like, "Oh, you get to fight Arnold Schwarzenegger," and I'm like, "No, I get to work with Rod Steiger," and it was really just. It's just really awesome because those guys are, it's a different generation of actor. I mean, like you guys said, I fell into this and I've been very lucky. Mm. I don't have that, you know, I come from this new generation of making television and movies where it's very mechanical. Those guys were trained in the theater and they lived and breathed that every day. Mm. And sometimes I kind of feel like a cheat that I don't have that process. But I'm a different generation of actor. You know, I have to learn how to act for the camera. So
yes, that's true.
Different times.
Well, definitely. Mo, we want to thank you for taking time out of your day to talk to us about Chicago Fire. And I got to say, if they have a L.A. Fire, are you going to at least audition for that?
Well, hopefully they'll just put me running the show. They'll put me as the chief in L.A.
There you go.
I love that, the spinoff. Just go right
to it.
Dick
Wolf has his reputation of branching out, so we don't know what's next. There could be an L.A. fire, Miami fire, who knows?
I want to be rescued by the team over there, so I'll be a victim any day for you guys, all right?
Oh, you got it. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you, Mo. Again, you can watch Mo and the rest of the crew on Chicago Fire every Wednesday night on NBC.